Hello, everybody. I'm Howard Tiersky, and welcome again to the Winning Digital Customer Show. Today, we will be talking about a topic that we got from one of you viewers, listeners, folks out there. Thank you all for watching. And I do periodically try to take a look at the questions you've sent in and make a show answering one or several of them. So today, one of the questions that I got from someone who watches the show, who is a senior executive at a large Fortune 500 company, asked the question, how can I speed up my digital transformation? My company has been engaged in digital transformation for what seems like a decade. And, you know, we've made some progress, but we really aren't where we need to be. What can we do to speed it up? So that is what we're going to talk about today. So first of all, what's your rush? Come on, enjoy the ride. There's no need to be in such a hurry, right? No, actually, it's the opposite. You know, as I often clarify, to me, what digital transformation means for a company is, well, it starts by recognizing that the world is changing, and it's been changing at an increasingly rapid pace. And while, of course, there are many changes in the world, the move towards digital and digital being more at the center of everyone's lives, whether it's their personal life, their work life, is just become more and more of a reality. And of course, coronavirus has accelerated that even more. So we live in a time of rapid change. And when we think about digital transformation at a company, it's really the process of changing that company, their value proposition, their customer experience, their way of having their workforce do business on a daily basis to keep up, essentially to keep up with the times, right? To keep up with the change in the world. So many companies, many large enterprises have not kept pace with the change in the world. They've changed, but they just haven't changed as fast as the world is changing. So it's like being in a race and you're running and the other runner is faster than you. Well, the farther you run, the farther ahead that other runner gets if he's faster or she's faster than you, right? And then what happened? Well, coronavirus sort of put turbo rockets on that other runner because now so many, not just companies, but your customers, most importantly, and your workforce, your employees, the people who make up your entire value ecosystem, they are becoming more and more digitally transformed every day. And so you have two choices. You can either transform to keep up with the times or frankly become obsolete and irrelevant. And that's why my book is called Winning Digital Customers, The Antidote to Irrelevance, because we don't want you to become irrelevant. And we're not here to scare you either, but to acknowledge that there is a risk, there is a threat out there. But the good thing is there are things to do about it. In fact, my book provides a sort of a step-by-step roadmap on how to do that. Today, we're not gonna try to give you a comprehensive roadmap, but I am gonna address the question that was asked, what can I do to speed up digital transformation? So first of all, I think the first thing you have to ask is, all right, you want to speed up your digital transformation. So how fast do you want to go? And it may sound like a little bit of a sarcastic question because, how do you measure the speed of digital transformation? It can't be measured in miles per hour, obviously. But it's important to have specific goals and targets and metrics to say, this is the speed that we consider to be acceptable. You know, I think a lot of people are at companies who are not keeping pace and they just want to speed up, but even they may not realize how much they need to speed up. So just to step back and say, okay, wait a minute, where do we need to be in order to be competitive? Where do we need to be at, and what pace of change do we need in order to be able to keep up with the world? And how are we going to measure that? You can measure it in the number of code releases you have per quarter or per week or per day, as they do at Facebook. You know, you can measure it in terms of specific new capabilities that you want to add. You can measure it in terms of the size of your digital portion of your business. There are many, many ways. And of course, we do a lot of work working with companies on how to set these targets. But you want to be specific about the goal because sometimes that in and of itself clarifies what you need to do. If you're only trying to get a little faster, you know, as Tony Robbins often says, when people come to him and say, my goal is to make more money, he says, all right, here's a dollar, gives it to him out of his pocket, you're done, right? Well, okay, they didn't really mean that. They want to make more than a dollar, but then how much? So be specific. How will you know when your digital transformation is moving fast enough? Until you know that, it's all kind of a vague, yeah, I wanna move faster. So that's the first thing. Try to get clear and specific about how fast you wanna go. And assuming that when you decide that, it's a lot faster than you're going now, then the most important question is, so what's holding you back, right? If I wanna go faster and I'm not already going faster, Well, I mean, if I'm walking and I want to walk faster, I just walk faster, right? It's not really a problem up into a certain point when maybe something is holding me back. What's holding me back? Well, you know, I'm getting out of breath or my legs hurt or whatever. So in the case of your goal of moving faster with your digital transformation, I want you to consider, well, what holds me back from moving faster? Now, that could lead you to brainstorm a whole bunch of different things that you might believe are the things that are holding you back. And they probably are. They may be technology related. They may be business process related. They may even be in terms of the adoption of your customers or there's a wide range of things, of course, that can hold you back. Getting clear on what those are in your case, because they're different from company to company, is important. But I want to suggest to you today that there is really one main thing that holds companies back. And then if you solve for that one main thing, everything else on your list probably can get taken care of by solving this one thing. So what's the one thing? What's the one main thing that holds companies back from going more rapidly in their digital transformation? Can you guess? It is, and now I'm trying to do the big reveal and my slide didn't change. It is alignment. Getting your organization truly aligned around the transformation. Because when you have a group of people that are absolutely aligned on a specific change that you're going to make or specific new idea of where you want to go, you can move pretty darn fast. But when you aren't aligned, then all the efforts that are being put in place very often are pulling against each other. It's like an isometric exercise. You know, I can hold my arm up and exercise my arm and use and exert a lot of force, but I'm actually keeping my arm in the exact same place because one muscle is fighting against another, or like a tug of war, right? So that's the number one problem. And I'm going to suggest to you that there are four main areas of alignment that you need to get right within your organization. And when you do, the speed of your digital transformation will take off. Now, there are some other challenges that you're going to need to encounter and deal with for sure. But with the momentum that comes from getting aligned in these four areas that I'm going to talk about today, you will be able to blow through all those things. So what are the four areas? The first one is urgency. Do you really need to change? You may very well have people within your organization who, you know, they're not necessarily convinced that you need to change, that you need to change big, and that you need to change now. No one's ever going to argue against some kind of idea that we could improve, that there's an opportunity to be better. Of course, who's going to say, no, we shouldn't do anything to try to get better? No one credible or who values their credibility will make that argument. But they certainly may make the argument that says, look, you know, I think we can do this in a measured way. We don't want to rock the boat. You know, we want to protect existing revenue streams. We don't want to overinvest. We don't want to be too early to market. There's all kinds of arguments and rationales for saying maybe we shouldn't move that fast. So if people aren't aligned around the need to move rapidly, and ideally, as I mentioned earlier, a specific set of goals that can be measured around speed, then you're going to have that pull. Because if you want to move fast, let's face it, change has negative consequences. It's absolutely essential for survival, but it has negative consequences. It creates disruption. It can make certain people's jobs irrelevant. It requires investment. It requires time focus, which takes away from possibly other things that you may want to do. So there's all kinds of good reasons to say, you know, there's some downsides to digital transformation. There absolutely are. Hey, if the world wasn't changing, if you could keep doing business exactly the way you're doing it without changing anything and be wildly successful, wouldn't that be better? I mean, yeah, that would be way better. Forget to don't buy my book. Don't do any digital transformation. Just stay exactly the way you are. If that was the world that we lived in. And you know, there have been some times when that was true. You know, if you look at the television and media industry where I do a certain amount of my work, there were decades when it really didn't change that much. You know, you had a certain number of channels on TV and they sold ads. And then there was a big change where cable came back in the 70s and early 80s. And then you had a period of relative stability where, okay, now you had more channels, but the industry operated in a certain way and didn't change that much until the digital revolution really came to streaming media. And at that point, of course, we have new disruption. So there are times when change is not as much of an imperative, but this is not one of those times. At the moment, change is essential. And you need to get alignment around that urgency. So how can you do that? Well, again, I'm gonna give you a few bullet points here. I go into this in great depth in my book, and we have actually other videos and articles that go into this in more depth too. But you know, it's a combination of the rational and emotional, right? Whenever you wanna persuade somebody of something. And so I think part of it is demonstrating the impact in the marketplace, demonstrating what your competitors are doing, painting the picture of what the business will look like without change, creating, as they say, the burning platform. And it can also be about inspiring people, which we're gonna talk about more in a moment, about what that change could mean from a positive perspective. In any case, my focus here today is to say, one of the four things you need to do is create more urgency. Okay, so if you have more urgency, if everyone absolutely agrees, great, change is essential, we must change, and we must change fast. Does that mean everybody's fully aligned? No. The next thing is vision. We can all agree to change, but change into what? When we talk about digital transformation, what does transformation mean? If you look it up in the dictionary, right? It means changing from being one thing to being something else. So probably everyone in your company knows what you are today, but what is that future transformed vision look like? Well, you know, if one part of the organization thinks you should transform in one way, and another part of the executive team thinks you should be transforming in the completely opposite way, in a totally different vision of what your company should become, what its products and services should look like in the future, how you should interact with customers, what your business model should be, where the work should get done, how you should be thinking about the labor force, your supply chain, your distribution chain. If you have wildly different visions, everyone might absolutely agree. It's sort of like if you and I are connected by a rope, and we absolutely agree that we need to go somewhere fast. And I say, yes, I think we should go west. And you say, I think we should go east. And we both start running as fast as and hard as we can. Well, we're going to go nowhere, right? Actually, we're going to go east a little bit because I'm stronger than you are. But nevertheless, whoever even makes any progress, it will be who's ever stronger, but their strength minus the strength of the other force, right? So again, if your digital transformation is going somewhere, but not fast, it may very well be because there's somebody where someone's pulling the vision in one direction, there's another force, a slightly less powerful force, but still creating an enormous amount of friction, pulling in the other direction. So getting everyone aligned around vision is essential. So many ways to do that. In our company, we do a lot of customer research and customer journey mapping, because most of the time you can get people aligned around business goals. Does everyone want more revenue? Does everyone want more profitability? Does everyone want to increase the share price? You know, it's the ultimate KPIs are usually something everyone can align around. But the question is, what's going to accomplish getting there? Which vision of the company is going to be most successful? So part of it is about brainstorming different alternate visions. And you know what? It's good to have different alternate ideas. You want a diverse set of ideas. And then what we do is use a research-based process to try to evaluate which of these visions have the greatest likelihood of success. You know, there's a lot of components to a digital transformation vision, but what I always say is the most important one is the customer experience, because that's where the money comes from. If you have a customer experience that successfully influences your customers to do the things you want them to do, you're probably going to be in really good shape as a business, right? If you get your customers to buy, if you, as a result of their desire, your cost of sales is low. If you get them to, you know, refer or to promote your products, to tell their friends about your products and services, if you get them to not return or refund or ask for exchanges, you get them to not haggle on price, you get them to interact with you on the less expensive self-service customer channels when you want them to. If you get your customers to do what you want them to do, man, it'll make up for an awful lot of sins in other parts of your organization. You know, there's other things for sure, but that's the number one most important one. So getting alignment around the vision. And we do all kinds of things also, like workshops, bring people together, make sure that all the key people who need to feel aligned, who need to be aligned, feel that they've really had a voice in an iterative visioning process, so that even if not every one of their ideas is the ultimate winning idea, they feel that they were a co-author of what that vision is. So again, a lot more on this in the book, but that's the second key area of alignment. First, if you recall, was alignment on that we need to change. Then the second alignment is, what do we need to change into? The vision. But the third is the plan. We could all agree that we need to create a new app that has XYZ features, but if some people are fighting to have the project implemented by the internal IT team and others want it implemented by an outside agency, And others want to partner with someone like Amazon or Google to get it done. And there's another plan and another plan. And everyone has a different idea of how to get from where you are to where you want to be. Well, you know what? That's going to be another one of those tug of wars. You see why alignment is so key? We can agree on several things, but if we still disagree on the plan, we're still pulling against each other in terms of actually getting somewhere, in terms of increasing our speed. So that's the third area, is getting clear on the plan. And there's many ways to do this. A couple of thoughts. The first is, try not to be a stickler for everything you need. You know, sometimes you have to be willing to give a little. If there's very often multiple successful paths to get where you want to go. I mean, if I'm sitting here, we live in New Jersey, if I'm talking to my wife and we're going to go into New York City, and I say, hey, let's take the George Washington Bridge. I want to take the George Washington Bridge to get across the river. And she says, no, I think we should take the Lincoln Tunnel. You know, and I have reasons why I want to take the George Washington Bridge. It's a better view, without a doubt, right? Would you rather have a beautiful view of the skyline and the river, or would you rather be stuck in a tunnel underground? I mean, to me, it seems obvious we should take the George Washington Bridge. But then she says, well, you know, if we take the tunnel, it's a shorter route and there's tends to be less traffic. So we'll get there faster. So she's got a good reason why she thinks we should take the tunnel. So what's the truth? Will both of these paths, will both of these routes get us to New York City? Yes, they will. We could sit in the driveway arguing for 2 hours about whether to take the bridge or the tunnel, which we haven't actually done, but you know, I'm adding a little bit of fictionalization to my marriage here for you, and probably run out of time and never get into New York City because we spent the whole evening arguing and our theater tickets are worthless because the play's over, right? Or we could just pick a path and go. And so that's my first thought on plan. Of course, there are totally wrong paths, right? If my wife says, hey, why don't we head towards Pennsylvania? That'll get us to New York. Well, it won't, right? So there are plans that will fail, but there are often many paths to success. And you want to encourage everybody, and that means you too, to be willing to have some sense of compromise around finding the right plan. And of course, there's much more to planning, but my goal here is to just give you kind of the high-level things, what's holding you back for being faster. The next is the expectation of perfection. Or another way of looking at this is risk. Everyone says, okay, let's say we agree on what the plan is and we agree on where we're going, but you know, how fast can we go and make sure that it's perfect? A lot of people have this feeling that, slow and steady wins the race, right? Like, let's not rush things out the door. We have a brand to protect. We have to have high level of quality. We need to make sure we do it right. Now, who can argue against quality? Who can argue against doing it right? Well, you know what? I can. I'll argue against that because it's often better to be fast than right. Successful companies in the digital space do not figure it all out in advance, pull one arrow back in the bow, and hit the bullseye. That's just not how it happens. They keep firing arrows, and they see as they fire different arrows how close or far they are from the bullseye, and then they adjust to get it right, to hit the bullseye. And that can take weeks, months, years of continuous change and iteration. So if you're taking the approach that we just have to incubate this a little bit longer, we just have to think about it a little longer, we need to strategize a little bit longer, that is holding back your actual ability to, you might say you have a digital transformation project going on, it's a bunch of people in a conference room working and giving PowerPoint presentations, but it's not necessarily doing anything yet. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying you shouldn't think things through, but you have to do it rapidly. And again, we have a whole bunch of techniques that we use, including workshops and other methods to accelerate decision-making. But also there has to be a cultural willingness to accept imperfection. The idea that failure, is part of success. And instead of trying to prevent failure by thinking everything through thoroughly and slowly, you get it out there and you accept that every one of those arrows that doesn't hit the bullseye is another indicator of what you need to do to adjust the bow, to adjust your aim, to get it in the center. And that mindset is key to successful transformation and to speeding up successful transformation. So those are my four areas. If you recall, the four were making sure that you have, they're all around alignment, right? So alignment is the key. I said alignment is our number one reason why we're not moving faster. And we said there's four areas you have to align around: the urgency, around the vision, around the plan, and around the willingness to accept risk and the willingness to have some level of failure so that you can execute that plan rapidly and not in a super careful way. Now, you might be saying, yeah, but I have other problems. Like, I have outdated technology in my company. You know, it's just, we just can't get what we need done because the technology won't permit. Well, I'm going to suggest to you that and many other examples that you could give me that you might have put on your list. Remember at the beginning, I said, hey, make a list of all the things that are standing in your way. I'm going to suggest to you that why do you have outdated technology? Or put it another way, if everyone was aligned around how critical it was to have modern digital platform that will allow you to build what you need, to integrate your data, to get new releases and new features out quickly, to test them. If everyone has agreed that that was essential and urgent, if everyone agreed on the vision of what that should be, meaning is it Java, is it .NET, is it in the cloud, is it on-prem, like the key decisions, everyone had a common vision of that. Everyone agreed on the plan, like who's going to do it, who's going to own it, what's the budget, what's the time frame, and everyone agreed that it was better to be fast and accept that, sure, there's always multiple paths and multiple options, and we don't know for sure what's the perfect answer, but we're going to get it done quickly, and we're going to be willing to not go for perfect. If everyone agreed on those four things, would you still have outdated technology? Now, how long would you have outdated technology or messed up business processes or a business model that's not aligned to a digital world or whatever it is? So I'm going to suggest to you that when you get those other four things worked out, which really adds up to just getting alignment, all these other things are very solvable, very, very solvable. So the problem is not outdated technology. The problem is alignment around what to do about it. But I do want to talk about one last thing before I let you go, because it's not usually possible to get absolutely everyone aligned around something. And you don't necessarily need 100% unanimous agreement in order to be able to move forward within an organization. If you did, you'd probably never be able to move forward with anything. So when we talk about alignment, we're usually not talking about that. We're talking about getting kind of a majority or all the key people. And of course, it's not a democracy, right? If your CEO is the one person who's not aligned, you probably got a big problem. But if you've got your CEO and 90% of his direct reports and a reasonable percentage of the people below that, then you probably have a good starting point. And in my other videos, in my book and other places, I talk about methods to bring people along and how to communicate about an ongoing digital transformation to make sure you're doing your very best to grow the support base and not let it shrink. But one of the problems that can also hold you back with digital transformation, even when you have alignment around a good portion of the people, is sabotage. And you need to expect that anytime you're driving a substantial transformation, there are some people within the organization who are its enemies. And it may be a minority, but if some of those enemies are powerful, influential, or just crazy determined, they may be able to create problems for you and slow you down. And the best thing I could advise is to know that there are many reasons why for any particular individual, they may not be on board. They may not like the urgency, or they may not like the plan. They may say, I run the call centers and this digital transformation is going to probably mean we need fewer people in the call centers, and therefore my empire will get smaller. So even though this may be better for the company, it's worse for me. I'm against it. And I need to figure out what I can do to sabotage this. And that's only one of many reasons. Some people say, I'm retiring in 2 years and my retirement is going to be based on, the revenue of the company or the stock price at the time of my retirement. And this digital transformation is really going to be investment today, which is going to reduce our profit in the short term for a future for the company. But I don't care about the long-term future. I only care about our profit this year. And so for me, this is a dumb thing. I don't want to make these investments because I don't care if this company's even around 2 years from now. I just want the maximum profitability for the company this year. That's what my bonus is tied to, or whatever it may be. That doesn't sound particularly a magnanimous way of looking at things, but we have to be realistic that most people will act on the basis of what are their own personal interests, which may not be the same as the interests of the greater organization or the individuals who that may be their colleagues. And so, I can't really get into, in the short video like this, all the details about what to do about it. But again, sorry to keep pointing you back to my book, but it's where I have the luxury of length to be able to expound on these topics in more detail. I go into what to do about sabotage. But I would just say this, the number one thing is forewarned is forearmed. So while there are, depending on the nature of the sabotage, there are many different types of actions you can take. And many are described in my book, but I would also say the number one is to just know and expect it. That way you'll be on the lookout for it. You'll know that any change has enemies. Try to figure out who they are. Pay attention to their moves. Don't be naive about their motives. It's not a fun way to go through life being distrustful of everybody, so I'm not suggesting that. But, it's like just because you're paranoid doesn't mean they're not out to get you, right? And when you're running a digital transformation, somebody is out to get you. I guarantee it, no matter how many people are supportive. So that's the last thing I wanted to talk about. You know, you can get started running fast and all of a sudden the parachute can come out the back of the car and it's like, what happened? Why do we slow down so much? Oh, because this group is having a committee to discuss whether we should change direction, or they're concerned about the spending, or they're not seeing fast enough impact, or, you know, our revenues declined last quarter, so we're looking to do budget cuts and we're thinking about putting the transformation on hold, or whatever it might be. And when you see those potential slowdowns happening, you have to see it for what it is. It's probably sabotage. And you need to take action against that, because success is not getting original alignment. Success is not getting your project approved. Success is not getting the funding. Success is getting to the finish line. And although you could argue with digital transformation, there's never an ultimate finish line because the world is going to keep changing. And so you're going to need to keep changing possibly forever. Nevertheless, your project, your initiative should have a finish line. It's that vision that you defined. You said, hey, we're going to take 18 months and we're going to make these changes and we're going to get to this level of capability, this new customer experience, this level of efficiency with our labor force or whatever it may be. Getting to the finish line on those things is key. And accomplishing that is almost surely going to require overcoming multiple attempts at sabotage. So hopefully that's useful. Hopefully that answers the question, at least at a high level. How do I speed up my digital transformation? Number one, get alignment. Make sure you have alignment around the urgency, the vision, the plan, and the willingness to take risks. And then that will help you overcome many of those next level issues, such as outdated technology. And then once you're going, just keep an eye out for sabotage. It's like you've got your car going at 200 miles an hour, but someone's put some tacks in the road, or it's like the Roadrunner, you know, the coyote is behind a rock with the plunger and he's put TNT. So you need to see that in advance and make sure you drive around it. So the coyote pushes the plunger down and, you know, it explodes and he's left just covered in soot like they always show in the cartoon. He never seems to get hurt though, right? No matter what happens, he's always in the next scene. And you know what? Your saboteurs are going to be like that too. No matter how many times you evade them, they're going to be scheming. They're going to be calling up the Acme Corporation and getting some new, those of you who don't watch Roadrunner are probably totally lost right now, but hopefully most of you have seen it, getting some new kit to find some new angle and some new way for sabotage. So just like the Roadrunner, who goes slow or fast? Fast, right? So it's the perfect analogy. That Roadrunner goes fast and he's always he is a Roadrunner, or he or she? I'm actually not sure. But anyway, always mindful of what that old wily coyote is doing and managing to get around or somehow overcome those traps and sabotage. And that's what you need to do too. So hopefully this was useful. I hope I answered, perhaps over answered the original question that came in. And with that, I want to thank you for watching and listening. Have a fantastic day, week, month. Hope your 2021 is off to a racing start. And reach out to us if there's anything we can do to help you, whether that's just answer a question on a live cast, or you want questions about the book or the courses that we do, you need consulting, anything like that. And absolutely be sure you like, subscribe. I'm not quite sure where you're watching this. It could be in a number of different places, but connect with us one way or another, because we want to make sure we're informing you on all the new content that we have coming out really every single week. So with that, have an awesome day. Thanks.